As a successful mobile game developer, one of the most important things you can continue to do is update your game with new content, bug fixes, and daily offers to keep your players engaged and entertained. But sadly, updating your game packages incorrectly can lead to a horrible burden of updates for your users. My name is Colt McCandless, and there's an easier way to push out data updates and keep your applications in sync. It's called Google Tag Manager. See, everything in your game is driven by data. Everything that makes up your game, like levels, animations, textures, localizations, sounds, even layouts, it's all data. And updating that data can become a problem. When you push a new version of your app, users are now caught in an application update cycle. That is, they can be notified that there's a newer version, but can decide to ignore it. As such, it's a common situation to have multiple versions of your game out in the wild, each one at different states of updates. In order to keep all your users on the same page and keep them from having to constantly download new versions of the game, you need a better way to distribute updates to your users. And this is where Google Tag Manager comes in. Tag Manager is a cloud-based service to deliver various types of text-based data to devices around the world. It prides itself on removing the curse of the upgrade cycle and keeping all of your users' devices in sync with the latest data. It does this by relying on a key principle. Different data in your game should be updated at different frequencies. See, there's a huge separation between fast-changing and slow-changing data in your app. Changing strings or translations may happen about once a week, while small tweaks to play balance, A/B testing, or offers may happen daily, while art or binaries may only change about once every 2 months or so. So, how does Tag Manager actually help? In a typical world, when you want to change your data, you do so locally, sign your package, re-upload it to the Google Play Store, and after some processing, your existing users will be notified that an update is available, and they can download the whole application update. But with Tag Manager, you can bypass most of this chaos. Since your data has been separated out from your code and binary assets, you push only the updated data to the cloud using Google Tag Manager console. The next time the user starts your app, it'll check if there's new data available and sync only the new information to the device. And rather than just sending out the same updated information to everyone, Tag Manager allows you to define a specific set of rules to help segment your user base and send them different content. See, users' devices will submit some sort of device info to Tag Manager when they check for updates. This is then tested against the set of rules dictating what types of updates they should receive, which then returns the properly updated data to the right user. These rules for data allow you to target specific segments of your user base and give them the data that doesn't influence everybody else. The best part is that all of this logic for syncing and keeping clients up to date is handled under the hood for you. Working with Tag Manager is as simple as interfacing with a few sets of APIs to fetch your data. And check this out, you can further extend the rules model in Tag Manager to create automated A/B testing for your app. Simply create an experiment in the Tag Manager console, which comprises of two things. Firstly, you need a rule set, which basically states what variables to change and what sets of users to test it on. For example, you might want to update the text on your offer screens for users who tend to buy in-game power-ups differently than those who buy vanity items. You also need to specify a desired action, which is the result of some user action on the device, like clicking a button, accepting a quest, buying an item, or killing an NPC. Once the experiment is set up, Tag Manager will do all the heavy lifting to roll out variable updates to subsets of your users on your behalf. You don't even need to think about it. And as users submit actions back to Tag Manager for your experiment, it's all collected and reported back to the console using the power of Google Analytics. So with Tag Manager, you get the best of your efforts. A way to distribute high-frequency changing data without users having to download the whole package again. You also get a set of rules which you can use to send specific updates to specific segments of your user base. And you get powerful experiments, which you can create dynamic, scalable A/B testing frameworks to improve your game with dynamic feedback over time, which is a lot of usefulness in a little bit of code. To get started with Google Tag Manager, head on over to the Tag Manager homepage and sign up for an account. This will give you access to the console, doc sets, as well as the library files to include in your client-side packages. Building a scalable game for millions of users is a monumental task to undertake, but with Google Tag Manager, you can ignore all that and focus on the real problems: zombies. Thanks for watching.